Hello there. I just wanted to introduce you to the next segment of our tour through art media. We're going to take a look at sculpture and the world of three-dimensional media. Sculpture is very different than painting, drawing, and photography, and other two-dimensional work in its ability to step into the viewer's world in a very direct and physical way. When you experience sculpture, you don't just experience it from one perspective. You view it from multiple angles. So it's like 1,000 compositions rolled into one. You also relate to it differently. When I go to Crystal Bridges and I step out of the elevators and see Louise Bourgeois' Mama spider sculpture in the courtyard, I experience it in a very direct way. It towers over me. I walk underneath it. So again, there's a unique relationship with the physical realm. Three-dimensional art is as ancient as two-dimensional art, and humanity has continued to sculpt forms for aesthetic delight and engagement. There are four different approaches to sculpture, sometimes depending on the media that one uses. There is carving, which involves cutting or chipping away a certain shape from stone, wood, or other material. This is considered to be a subtractive process, so material is taken away from the outside in. Michelangelo's Pietà is an example of this approach to sculpture. Then there's modeling. Modeled sculptures are created when a soft material, like clay, is molded and shaped to create a form. There's assembling. This is when sculptors join together different materials to create an assembled sculpture. An example of this would be David Smith's Cubi series, in which he assembled these stainless steel geometric shapes to create these new forms. Lastly, there's casting. This is when you have a material that's melted down, usually a metal, and that is then poured into a mold. When the mold cools and the metal hardens, you have this form that emerges. We see sculpture made in molds all the time, from plaster decor to chocolate Easter bunnies. Molds are an economic way to create a form without it being completely solid. Bronze casting has been going on for a long time. It was used a lot by the ancient Greeks, and you can see it used to create famous works like Rodin's Thinker. When working with various media and sculpture, there are certainly pros and cons. While softer material may be easier to form and mold, it's also easier to break, and so it becomes important for the artist to really know the strengths and the weaknesses within each media. Like every media, sculpture is an art form that continues to change and transform with the currents of culture. One of the three-dimensional art forms dominating contemporary art is called installation art. This is an art form that may even take up an entire room or gallery space because it's focused on how you, the viewer, experience the work. Installation art is often put into a different category from sculpture because it tends to be large scale and is often designed for a specific place or for a certain period of time. I came to appreciate three-dimensional art when I took a sculpture class in college, and we had to create work in all these various forms, and I realized how much thought and design had to go into creating works that could be viewed from multiple angles and in various lighting. I also realized how much you really have to know the media, its potentials and pitfalls. And I also came to appreciate just the physical demands of some of the media. I remember being given a hammer and chisel, and you know, 40 hours later, I can't even lift my arms and I have to bust out the Dremel. So these experiences, they certainly helped me just appreciate the dedication of so many sculptors to their craft and process. And it's also exciting to see how new sculptural media and methods continue to shape and transform three-dimensional art. I hope you enjoyed this quick overview of sculpture. We'll see you next time.